Glaucus, Atlanticus. Common names include the blue sea dragon, sea swallow, blue angel, blue glaucus, dragon slug, blue dragon, blue sea slug, and the blue ocean slug. These sea slugs are pelagic. They float upside down by using the surface tension of the water, where they are carried along by the winds and ocean currents. The blue side of their body faces upwards, blending in with the blue of the water. The silvery gray side of the sea slug faces downwards, blending in with the sunlight reflection of the sea ocean surface when viewed facing upwards underwater. Blue dragons store stinging nemesis from the siphonophores within its own tissue as defense against predators. Humans handling the slug receives a very painful and potentially dangerous sting. This nudibranch is pelagic, and there is some evidence that it occurs throughout the world's oceans. In temperate and tropical waters, it has been reported from the east to the south coast of South Africa, European waters, the east coast of Australia, and Mozambique. The blue dragon species range increases northwards by 150 kilometers in the Gulf of California. Since the middle of the 19th century, records of this species have been reported on the Azores. The blue dragon was recently found in Peru in 2013 and in India in 2012. This is in line with the known habitat characteristics of the species. They live in warm temperate climates in the southern Pacific. These nudibranches were documented as having been seen in the Bay of Bengal and off the coast of India, over 677 kilometers apart. Although these sea slugs live on the open ocean, they sometimes accidentally wash up onto the shore, and therefore they may be found on beaches. The blue dragon can reach up to 3 centimeters, 1.2 inches in length, though larger specimens have been found. It can live up to a year under the right conditions. It is silvery gray on its dorsal side. It has dark blue stripes on its head, and it has a flat, tapered body and 6 appendages that branch out into the right. The blue dragon is able to swallow venomous nemesis from various cytophores, such as the Portuguese man-o-war, and store them in extremities of its finger-like serratas. Picking up the animal can result in a painful sting. Symptoms similar to those caused by the Portuguese man-o-war. The symptoms that may appear after being stung are nausea, pain, and even vomiting. Thank you guys for watching. Stay safe, and I'll catch you in the next one.